Hiya, Pat. Right, I'm on my way to meet up with some fellow motorcyclists at Green Bridge. Colin will be there. I think Charlie from RestDayRider should be there, and all the other usual culprits. And then we're riding to the Motorhub Ride It Day, which is near Bybury. Motorhub, it's featured on the channel in the past. It's a very interesting venue, lots of old vehicles. I think this one is especially for motorcycles. I'm riding my Suzuki V-Strom 1000 2018 model, and I'm also wearing a new motorcycle jacket. I bought myself an air mesh jacket, and I'm wearing, because it's a bit chilly at the moment, this is basically, I basically bought it for summertime, because in the real hot summer, wearing motorcycle clothing is blooming uncomfortable unless you're moving. So the air mesh jacket is going to keep me nice and cool, but when it gets cool, then it'll keep you nice and cold, which you don't want. So I'm wearing over the top of the air mesh jacket a cagoule or a waterproof top. I like this idea because, hang on, something's rattling away. I like this idea because it's twofold. It means I haven't got to carry heavy clothing, and when I'm not motorcycling, I want to go out for a walk, or when I'm at a camp or whatever, I've got my waterproof top. So it's a win-win on both those fronts. So anyway, I'll bring you back when I'm at Green Bridge. So here we are, we're at Green Bridge roundabout. I did cast my eye, I can see a lot of motorcyclists over there now, so looks like there's been a good turnout today. Yeah, big turnout. I see Charlie's trying out Dave's Ducati for size.
They meet at the same place as the VMCC.
All right, okay.
We sort of suggested this would be an ideal opportunity for the two clubs to meet together.
Oh, lovely.
You filming?
I am, yeah. Hang on a sec.
Morning, Sandy.
Morning, Charlie. How are you?
All right.
I'm alright, I'm on a proper motorbike for a change.
You've bought the V-Strom. I don't think I've seen this one.
No, this is lovely bike. This is what I do all my big tours on. It's a V-Strom 1000. It's a 2018 model. And they all share the same engine. This engine, it's a 1037cc V-twin. And it's one of the most reliable motors in a motorcycle. There's a V-Strom in North America with over 400,000 miles on the clock. And the engine hasn't been apart.
400,000.
You feel planted.
Yeah.
You know, when you're on a motorway and you're cruising along, you're planted. You know, whereas with the Himalayan, if you're doing 70, you're sort of on it, sort of like. It's beginning to get a bit breathless, isn't it?
A little bit.
Yeah.
But we love them.
Yeah, of course we do. They're brilliant bikes. Okay, Colin, where is he? Yeah, I'm set up for you. I'm set up for you. It'll record, you know.
Hey, good morning, everybody. How are you?
I see you've got your big red man sausage extension.
Absolutely. Nothing like a man sausage extension on a Sunday morning. Lovely job.
Good for you. Right, Colin, tell us about.
Good morning there, Wiltshire man. Welcome to the group today. We've got
morning,
Vintage Motorcycle Club. We've got the Royal Enfield Owners Club, and we've got the Swindon Scooter Club. Because it's Tim's club meet at the same rat trap where we meet, we've decided we'll all have an inter-club meeting today, and as you can see, there's an awful lot of scooters today.
Yeah.
So we're looking forward to a nice little ride out to the motorhome.
Right, so Dave's now the cameraman. So I'll show him a jacket. Dave sold me this jacket, didn't you, Dave? I'm really pleased with it because it's really lightweight. It's got full protection, shoulders, elbows, and in the back. Really, really nice. Belt and braces. MS jacket. Great for the summertime. Colin's going, look. Not a bad turnout for Green Bridge, is it? Looks like one of the scooters has had a breakdown. Oh dear. Got Charlie from RestDayRider riding Roger in front. I'm not sure who we've got behind. So it seems that Colin is leading the pack, and what he'll do if a gap appears, then he'll slow up and wait for the rest of us to catch up with him. But certainly riding behind a lot of scooters, you can definitely smell them. Colin mentioned the rat trap earlier. Well, that's the pub where they all meet there. So it looks like we're turning into the little village of Stanton Fitzwarren. Clear. Although the Ducati is really nice to look at and really nice to listen to, apparently Dave says it's not the most comfortable machines to ride, so I wouldn't want to ride it for a long distance. Smell the lovely two-stroke smoke again. It seems that the scooter crew want to ride together. You know what they say? Birds of a feather flock together. When I was a kid, my two elder brothers, Stephen and Robert, Stephen was a skinhead, and he wanted a scooter, and Robert was a greaser, and he had long hair, and he wanted a motorbike. Very curious wind pump over there with a reservoir that's mounted on its reservoir. It's quite unusual, that. Now we're entering the Cotswolds and the little village of Quennington. Fantastic view across the valley. If you're on it, you can see it, but it's a bit misty at the moment. It really is a nice view. Look at that. Now we're in the Bybury. A nice trout stream coming up on my left. Loads of Chinese and Japanese tourists. Well, it's quite quiet at the moment this time of the year. The last time I came to the Motorhub, I met up with Henry Cole and Alan Millyard and a few other motorcycle celebrities, and I got a good feeling they'd be here again today. So it'd be good to meet up with those people again. Go and pull in over here. Booked in, yeah, booked in. Cut. That was a nice ride, Charlie, wasn't it?
That was so pretty.
Small, you're on candid camera.
Oh, that was so pretty.
She's heavy.
Charlie's on the mighty Strom, look.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's the biggest lump.
It's the biggest lump, but once you're moving, I guess.
Oh, yeah, it's like any other bike. Once you're moving, it's really,
really
nice.
Well, that suspension's really kind of the boing, the boing.
0-60 in about 3 seconds.
Now, I prefer this tank. I mean, it's very identical to that, actually.
Yeah,
so you've got an awful lot more capacity.
Yeah.
Well, you need a bit more fuel because it's a bigger engine, you see.
Yeah.
But once it's going, it's a pussycat to ride.
Is it?
Unless you want to open it up.
And then it behaves.
Yeah, I mean it will, but you've got traction control as well, so you can knock traction control off, and then you can do all sorts of funny things then if you want.
And it does 0-60 in what?
About 3.1 seconds.
That's quite quick,
so, and it's, but that's not the fastest, though.
What size is it?
It's 1,000.
Is it?
1037.
Wow.
Yeah. It's got a beautiful V-twin engine. It's a lovely machine, and you don't have to work it.
It's actually remarkably... It is heavy to get it up initially, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, well, but they all are, though, aren't they?
Yeah.
But the engine, it's very low revving, and it's very torquey, because it's a V-twin. It should go onto the side stand and then take its weight. Because it's a V-twin, you don't have to work it hard.
You've got longer legs than me, Sandy.
Because it's a V-twin, you don't have to work it hard. All the power is there instantly. It hasn't got like a power band where you've got to work an engine up, then suddenly it goes. This goes from the bottom straight on up, you know.
It's remarkably...
It's a comfortable seat as well.
It's very comfortable, and that suspension is very pointy.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Oh, yeah. Just found a scooter on its side stand, look.
Young boy, dumb and bad, yeah, when I did me wrong. When you're young, you get sad. When you're young, you get sad. You get high. Oh, man. Young girl, dumb and bad, yeah, she went and did me wrong. Young girl, dumb and bad, yeah, she went and did me wrong. So I got high. Lord, I got high. I got a bone to pick with you. Sure, you know it's true. Go on day when you're looking back. You were young and bad, you were sad. When you're young, you get sad. When you're young,
this is Mark, he's a subscriber of mine.
Certainly am.
He's going to show me his royal alloy.
Follow me.
There she is, Sandy, in all her glory.
What a beautiful bike, isn't it?
Yes, I'm very pleased with it, very pleased. As I say, I'm running it in at the moment, very carefully. So I sat at the back of the group today.
Yeah.
But yeah, very comfortable.
It's a little 125.
Little 125,
but it goes fast enough for what you want.
More than.
Yeah.
More than, to be honest.
It's a very neat looking bike, Mark.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm very pleased with it. Got great service when I was buying it.
Yeah.
I don't work for them, but they were very good.
Yeah.
And I just enjoy getting out and about with the lads on the scooters.
It's nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it's nice. It's a whole new dimension for me.
Yeah.
Just to come out and get some fresh air and meet different people.
Can you get it in a bigger engine capacity as well?
You can get it in a 300.
Oh, that'd be lovely, wouldn't it?
Yeah, you can get that in a 300, which gives you that a little bit more room, obviously.
Yeah.
But as I say, not having passed my test, I am restricted to a 125, but plenty for me.
Yeah. So Julie, if you're watching, look, your colleague here.
Hi, Julie, hope you're well.
He's famous now, look.
Oh, fame at last. I've waited long enough for it.
This is Mike. This is Mike's bike. But secretly, Mike wants to be riding this.
I could put it in my top box as a kind of a backup.
You could do, yeah.
Thank you.
I'll see you later, Mike. Bye, Pierre.
See you, man. Go well.
Oh well, all good things must come to an end. See ya!
See you later.
Time to head back. Well, coming here, I was wearing a waterproof cagoule or a raincoat over this jacket, and now I'm not. And I'll tell you what, I'm really benefiting from the cool breeze, because it's turned out to be quite a nice hot day. So yeah, the jacket's a winner for me. I'm glad I got it. It'd be great for summertime. So anyway, now heading back off home. Met some wonderful people there. Didn't get a chance to speak to Alan Millyard or Henry Cole, but they were there. But I did meet up with some subscribers, and it was it's really good to meet them. Like-minded people, shall we say. Anyway, thanks for watching the video. I'm now going to enjoy the lovely ride home, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.